We'll be changing oil in the transmission. So in order to do that, we're gonna have to drop this cover, support over here, transmission, takes this mounting bracket off, and then unscrew the bolts on the transmission pan. Drain the oil and then unscrew the bolts on the transmission pan and drop it down, change the filter and put it back in with a new seal. Got a new seal, new transmission filter, and new bolts. So let's begin. Okay, covers are off. Now we're taking this bottom frame support, or whatever name is. Then we're gonna have to disconnect this transmission cable shifter. So in order to do that, there is two clips on the side, on one side and the other side. So we have to push those clips in and slide this connector out, and then there's a little latch right here, so that's how it sits right here. So we pull that up and get this cable out. So then after this, we're gonna be supporting our transmission over here, because we will be unscrewing this back transmission support in order to get to the bottom of the pan to get the bolts out. So there is a drain plug and fill and level plug. Next thing, taking this mount. Transmission support is out. So this piece sits like this. So this piece bolts to the transmission with the three bolts. And then on the other side, those three bolts are sticking out. That's where this mount goes on the top of it, just like that, and secures with the three nuts in here. You don't have to unscrew those two bolts. So three bolts, and 1, 2, 3, 4 to get this mount out. And then this one has also three bolts. Show you guys on the transmission. So that's how it's sitting like this. So in order to get to those bolts over there for the oil pan, this mount has to come out just like that. And when you do that, guys, have a 10 millimeter socket ready. Because when you unbolt those four bolts, so there is a transmission cable secured in this bracket. So I'll show you. This cable secured on that mount. So have a 10 millimeter socket ready to unscrew when you take those four big bolts out. And that's what I use to support the transmission. A chair, and a stand, and I support it here on the back. Alright, bottom pan is out, filter is out. That's how it looks like. So the filter goes over here. That's the side that goes to the bottom of the pan. And that's how it goes. That's how it goes into the transmission. And for those who think that we don't need to change the transmission oil, so this is the magnets right here and right here. So look at how much we got here. So this is all metal that got stick to the magnets. This is all filing a lot. Look at that. So that's what it is. New filter, new gasket, pan back, new oil in. New filter in, got the bolts tied, so 4 Newton meters each bolt plus 45 degree turn. And in order to not miss any, every one that I've done it, I marked. Have to make a gravity flow pail that I'll raise a higher than transmission, secure somewhere there on the top, and I'm just gravity flow from the pail into the transmission. So in order to do that, so I put the pail also I bought this plug. I'm gonna drill the hole in the pail. I put the rubber O-ring in here, and then I'll go through the pail and put the nut on top of it, tight it. And then on this barb, I'm gonna put 1/2-inch hose, clear hose. I bought it already. So then after this will be a valve and a 90 that will go into the transmission. This is what I made. Pail, drill the hole, put the nipple through, hose, valve and 90 degrees to feed into the transmission. So I'm gonna lift the pail, fill the pail with oil, lift the pail higher than transmission and gravity flow oil into the transmission. Ready to dump the oil in, so that's how I secure the pail on the top. Then the hose runs down, down, valve, and it goes right into the fill port or opening.